colleague Jessica Kilmon from Great Schools. She's the managing editor, and she will be joining us for the next hour to walk us through the Great Kids State Test Guide for Parents. As I mentioned earlier, my name is Jessica Rodriguez, and I am the Education Outreach Manager with National Council of La Raza. And we are very excited for our webinar today. We're going to learn about this online tool that can be used by Hispanic parents to learn more about statewide assessment results, the Smarter Balance test, as well as the PARC test, as well as tools for parents to help their children at home with learning activities. And so two housekeeping items for folks. The first is that everyone will be muted for the presentation, but please type your questions into the chat, and at the end of the presentation, we will move to questions and answers. The second thing is that this webinar will be recorded. So at the end of this presentation, I will provide you my email address so you can feel free to email me so I can give you a link to this recording. With that, I'll turn it over to Jessica. And folks, if you have any questions, just chat it into the box and I'll be controlling it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Jessica. And you guys, thank you so much for the opportunity to talk about the State Test Guide for Parents. We're really excited about it. We're excited about getting resources into the hands of parents, as I know you guys are too. I'm going to go ahead and start with a really short presentation, and then we'll go straight into the tool. The presentation is just mainly to let you know some of the background of this tool. So, the Great Kids State Test Guide for Parents. First of all, Great Schools is where I work. We are a nonprofit, and our goal is to get a great education for every kid in this country. And Great Kids is our journalism outlet. It's one half of our site. This is where we write research-based articles and resources for parents. So this is where the tool lives. And you can find it at statetestguide.org, and I'll do that in 1 second to make it as easy to find as possible, but you can also find it from our homepage. Our goal is to help parents adopt a problem-solving mindset in response to their child's performance on new state tests. Really, what we want to do is help parents help their kids. We know all the research says every parent wants their child to be successful. We want to help them do it, just like you do. Our solution is the state test guide. It's not all just about test scores, but it starts here, and that's where this guide starts, is this gives you a map. It gives parents are going to get a report in the mail, and it's going to say how their kids are doing, and we are trying to make this guide align with what they get. So if you're in an SVAC state, you'll see there's if you're in a PARC state, and you got your math report for your child, you'll see that there's claims like major content, additional and supporting content, mathematical reasoning, and there's another one called modeling and application. We organized it with the claims so it could be very familiar for parents, so they can go exactly to what their kid did and where they need to work on, so they know exactly what they need to read and what they are reading. So here is an example of a state report. Not all the states are designed the same. In PARC states, they are. And you can see how kids, where they scored. So state average 731 would be a level 3. So what we think is that parents are going to be most concerned when their child is below expectations. So you'll see in the tool, we designed it around that. We want to go straight to the claim where kids are having trouble. So the idea is that you go, here you see Colorado State Test Guide. We have a lot of vanity URLs like that, but statetestguide.org gets you to the exact same place. So that's the URL to remember. And here, let's say Emily scored low in fifth grade vocabulary. So you would go to ELA, English Language Arts Literacy, fifth grade, and go straight to the claim reading vocabulary. And here it opens up with what they're learning. This is what it means. the first three things, a bulleted list. This is what, in a nutshell, what this claim means. Within the tool, you're going to see a bunch of our milestone videos, and I will show you a couple. They're in English and in Spanish, and they're nice and short, very accessible. And then right under what it means is that if your child didn't meet the reading vocabulary standard, these are the top reasons why a child might have fallen short. These are the difficult areas, and we want parents to understand it might not be true for every child, but for the most part, these are the hard parts. So these are the things to focus on. And then we go into how to help. And this is where we think we add absolutely the most value, because this is where we try to help parents help without getting a teaching degree, ways that they can help at home, things that they need to understand about how to help. So we'll look at that more in depth in the tool itself. A couple things about this. It's free for everyone, and it's going to remain free. We are a nonprofit. This is what we do. It currently covers grades 3 through 8. There is testing in 11th grade, and I think we shall see if we're going to create 11th grade. But for right now, 3rd through 8th. We have a tool built for SBAC, Smarter Balanced, and a tool built for PARC. We organize them, like I said, around those claims that parents are getting on their child score reports. However, if you lived in, say, Texas, you could still use this tool. You pick either one, SBAC or PARC, and you could read through it, especially what it means and the how to helps, because as long as your state has high education standards, these are going to be grade by grade what they're looking for, no matter what they call the claim. We work really hard to do this with experts and teachers. So I want to make it very clear that we at Great Schools did not just read the standards and make this up. We have looked at the research. We worked with teachers in every state. We worked with SBAC teachers and PARC teachers. We worked very closely with the PARC experts on ELA and math. We have had all of our work reviewed by SAP, Student Achievement Partners. The reason it's free is because it was funded by various trusts and foundations who are interested in education in America. And the Learning Heroes, you will see in our How to Help section, Learning Heroes has collected a lot of online resources for parents, and we link to them all throughout the tool so that parents can get there easily and quickly. Finally, we have a partner toolkit page that Jessica is going to share with you at the end, that where you can get resources to share with parents. One sheet that you can hand out that are going to give the statetestguide.org URL that you can go ahead and share. And also, I just wanted to put this on here. Our director of communications, Steve Padilla, is actually out sick today, but he is a great resource. And you have my direct email now, jkelman@greatschools.org. Feel free to email me anytime. So thank you so much for watching this presentation. Let's go straight to the tool now. So I'm going to start with Smarter Balanced, partially because this is the tool we built first. And I'm going to go ahead and keep fifth grade as our example for now. But feel free, at any time we can switch around. This tool was built, and I think this is a good note for Spanish-speaking parents, to make it easy to toggle back between English and Spanish. Pretty much every single thing that you see here in English is in Spanish. There are a few tiny exceptions, but for the most part, it's all there and all in Spanish. And the exceptions would be where the resources are in English. And for the most part, we have included those with a little note to parents saying, these are good resources, but they are in English. So on an SBAC, in a Smarter Balance test, like a state like California, when you got your child's score report, you would see in ELA, there are four claims: reading, writing, speaking and listening, and research. So let's say Emily's mom gets her score, and Emily is below proficient in reading and needs to work on reading. First thing it opens up to here is what they're learning. And this is an explanation of so-called complex text, making sense of new words, understanding the main idea. And so what we've done is we've embedded some of our videos, milestone videos. Watch how a teacher gets fifth graders to show what they're learning as they read. And right here in the tool.
How do you know your fifth grader understands what they read? By now you've done it a million times. Ask a question about the reading, and most fifth graders can answer it. But they should also be able to point to evidence, a sentence or a picture, to show you how they know the answer.
Some volcanic eruptions happen suddenly and explosively. Others happen over a long period of time. This is true of America's longest active volcanic eruption.
I want to know whether this mountain, Kilauea, is a sudden explosion or an eruption over a long period of time.
I think it's an eruption that happens over a long period of time because it says this is true of America's longest active volcanic.
But by the end of fifth grade, they should be able to answer the not-so-obvious questions and point to the sentence or sentences that show how they know the answer. Here, Jackson has to infer the answer from what he reads.
It had been 4 o'clock by the time he'd gotten back into his room, and he was still tired.
He got back to his room at 4 o'clock. Morning or night?
Morning.
How do you know?
It had been 4 o'clock by the time he'd gotten back to his room, and he was still tired. His night expedition hadn't been quite the success he'd hoped.
So how do you know if your child understands what they're reading? Well, come summer, fifth graders should be able to show understanding by answering more complex questions about a book and by pointing to evidence of the answer.
So these milestone videos are in every claim, and they're in Spanish as well, which we'll see in just a moment. So this is kind of the overall what they're learning here. We try to boil it down to a nice, concise level of information, and then under one no more, we go a little deeper. We add some of the extra stuff. We kind of put the main concepts up top, and we go a little deeper, or put some of the extra concepts that they are expected to know, but that are maybe not like the major content in one and no more. And then we go straight to if your child didn't meet the reading standard, because of course this is where parents are going to go. They want to know, well, why? Why not? And so these are the main reasons that children struggle with this particular claim. And then we go straight to how to help. And here we have a collection of on-site ideas and off-site links. And what we're doing here is we want parents to know research-based practices that they can do. They are meant to be free and easy and, you know, no teaching degree required. We know that in fifth grade, there's a push all along in the standards to read more complex texts. And so what we've done is we've gone ahead and created assets. Here, what we've got is complex books for fifth graders. This right now exists only in English, but look for this to exist in Spanish soon. And right now, of course, in this Spanish tool, we link to this list so parents can still get the exact same information, and soon you should be able to find it in Spanish as well. So we've got, we encourage family reading time, reading for your own pleasure, questions to ask your child about what he reads. This was a big one from teachers and experts, is specific questions, not just what did you read? But these are the types of questions that at this grade level, children should be able to answer. Vocabulary, this is a big one, and actually in Park States, it's its own claim. But it's within reading in SBAC, and so we talk about ways to build a vocabulary. And here we've got the Be a Learning Heroes lessons. So we link off here. And Be a Learning Hero has done some great work putting together their learning tools. This actually, here you can search by grade and by subject, and actually that link that I just showed you needs to be fixed because it usually goes straight to where it goes. This is a living, breathing document, and we are still fine-tuning a couple last-minute things. So you'll see a little things like that that are going to be fixed. That one we fixed at the end of this presentation. In writing, same things. We've got what they're learning. We've got a video, which shows. This one shows what the writing process looks like in fifth grade, and this one shows what teachers are looking for in your child's writing. We've got both in Spanish. And then again, we've got the Wanna Know More. Here we've got links to real fifth graders' writing. So parents can open up real kids' writing and see, okay, this is what it looks like. You know, you wanna know how advanced the language needs to be, how long it needs to be, what kind of spelling and grammar errors you're still seeing in fifth grade. And that's nice to be able to see that right there. Again, if your child didn't meet the writing standard, we've got four bullet points on the main reasons why, and then we go into how to help. And all of these are just fun ideas to get your child writing at home. Have your child write a short bio about a family member. Write to a fan club or a kids magazine. Practice thinking about pros and cons of two different ideas, which sets kids up for writing later on where they need to address both sides of an argument. Talking it out, the idea that writing begins with thinking and talking. So again, here we've got more online tools that you can use, that parents can use easily. There are games, there are activities that are related to writing in this case. So this has been the SBAC tool in English. What I'd like to do is switch over to PARC and show you math. On the PARC tool, we've got, it's surprisingly similar to SBAC. It's just organized by the content claims, as I mentioned before. So major content, additional and supporting content, mathematical reasoning, and modeling and application. So true to their names, major content is the major stuff. This is the most stuff in the grade. So it's the longest. Something that we've done here and that we're going to do for the SBAC tool in the next week or two is we've gone ahead and done a bulleted list. So fifth graders are expected to learn, here's the quick and dirty on what they're expected to learn. Then in Want to Know More, we've got a lot more. We break down these bullet points. So fractions, you notice fractions goes right down here, and here's where you can learn a lot more about what's expected of children in fifth grade when it comes to fractions. And does your fifth grader know how to add and subtract fractions? We've got a video, and I'll show you that one in Spanish. Multiplying fractions, understanding multiplication, dividing fractions, etc. So we've got a lot of visuals here. When we talk about place value, we want parents to understand place value as well. What we tried to build is a tool that can help parents help with homework. And so here, if they didn't meet the major content standard, we explain what the hardest things are, and then we go ahead and we do sample problems in English and in Spanish and with answers explained. And so in orange, what we've got is the explanation for the answer to this problem. In major content, there are lots of sample problems. In the other ones, there's one or two. But this is meant to be a resource for parents, especially as Common Core math has changed. Parents are seeing math homework that's different. And our tool can be a nice way of looking at some of these and saying, oh, okay, that's what it is. So for those inclined to help with math homework, we think the sample problems with solutions is going to be a really nice tool. I think right now is a good time to switch over to Spanish. So right here, you can get to our test guide from our homepage, and state test guide's right here. To get started, you select your state. We'll go with Colorado because it's a PARC state, and go back to fifth grade. And it takes you right in. And you can go straight into Spanish right here. I'm sorry, you know what I meant to show you? One moment. From our homepage, state test guide is right here. You can go straight into Spanish from here. So parents can go directly into Spanish. So here we are, fifth grade math in a park state. Major content is right here. Open it up, we've got the same bullet points with examples. And then you open it up to Want to Know More. And here we go. So let's watch one of these milestone videos about finding common denominators and fractions in Spanish.
Cuando los niños se están convirtiendo en preadolescentes, las fracciones son tan comunes en sus vidas como los cambios de humor y las ironías. En quinto grado, su hijo va a aprender a sumar y restar fracciones con distinto denominador o diferentes números en la parte inferior. Para sumar o restar fracciones con denominadores diferentes, tienen que saber cambiar una o ambas de las fracciones para hacer que los números de abajo sean iguales.
I mean that 5 times 3 is 15, so I used 15 as my common denominator, and then I got 14, 15.
Es posible que usted no recuerde cómo hacerlo, pero para el final de quinto grado, quizás se sorprenda con la rapidez y facilidad con la que su hijo trabaja con fracciones. Entonces, ¿cómo saber que su hijo va en buen camino? Para cuando llegue el verano, los estudiantes de quinto grado deben ser capaces de sumar y restar fracciones que tienen diferentes denominadores rápidamente y con facilidad.
And so moving on in fractions, we've got another one, another video, also in Spanish, about, you know, does your child understand the rules of multiplication? So this is where we go ahead and same graphic as before, but just in Spanish, explaining place value and volume. The same bullet points, you know, if your child fell below the standard in this claim, why? Why might that be? And then right underneath it, relating right to these bullet points are sample problems with their solutions, all in Spanish. So what I want to show you, though, which I think is, you know, what it means and what they're being tested on is very important. It's huge. But the how to help, again, is really where we add so much value and where parents can really start to understand how they can help. In math, the research shows that a parent's attitude towards math is huge. Throughout English and Spanish, the first tip in our how to help all grades is why it's important is to have a good attitude towards math. Every single one is different, though, and some of them are quite funny, so it's nice to look through there. There's a Winston Churchill quote in one of them. There's a brain teaser in one of them, but all of them are about the power of a good attitude towards math and how that is. Parents can communicate a bad attitude towards math and contribute to math grades dropping off. So the number one thing all parents can do in math, have a good attitude, speak about it nicely. So then we have what we are calling sprinkles and boosts. So in math, sprinkle math into everyday activities. And what we do is we give, you know, three or four in every grade and every claim games and activities parents can do at home. Like what fraction of the day does your child spend watching TV or sleeping or doing homework? Challenge your child to, you know, make up these fractions, figure out these fractions. And then under the sprinkles, what we call, it's called boost those skills. And boost those skills are all links to different ways that parents can help. So this is a Khan Academy video in which he explains, I think volume, oh no, word problems, in which he explains word problems. Please excuse my slow translation into Spanish. This is an explanation by CK12 about how to divide a whole number by a fraction. Skill Builder, we've linked to Learning Heroes Skill Builder. This one's working correctly. 24 math games. What's great about these is math, they're all electronic math games, all can be played online. They're, and math has the universal language, so it shouldn't be much of a language barrier to participate in these games and play them online. We have also linked to our related worksheets. Great Schools has about 3,000 free worksheets, all of them available for free. What we've done is we've called out the ones that are relevant to this claim and grade, and they can be printed right here online and easily accessible. So we've got volume, decimals, etc. And then what we've also done is we have a couple of stories about why certain games like Multiplication War, Monopoly, and Set are great games that you just play for fun, but they build math skills, and we've got little write-ups on them, but just a reminder to parents that learning math can be really fun. Play around a Monopoly. And then all math sections end with talk to your child's teacher. And it can be so difficult to talk to a child's teacher. You know, there's a language barrier, and then with math, if you're not a math whiz yourself, sometimes it can be really tricky to figure out what to say. So what we've gotten here are sample questions, kind of getting to the nitty-gritty, kind of getting right to the point, like here's a question to ask to get the discussion started. And every grade, every claim, we have this, and they're all specific to that claim and grade. So let's look, let's go back over to English. I mean, let's go back over to ELA in Spanish for fifth grade. So again, we're working still in PARC here, so we've got the fiction, the nonfiction, vocabulary, written expression, and then basically grammar. Let's start with fiction. So here we've got up top the bullet points. It's just the quick and dirty on what they're learning. And so if they want to know more, they can open it. But if they don't want to, they can go straight to why children struggle with reading in this grade. And they want to know more. We've got the milestones in Spanish. So we've already watch this one. Let's watch a different one. Reading in Spanish, how to help. One thing that we've added to the Spanish version of across the grades and claims is this first section, your participation makes a difference. We are just citing the research-based ways that parent help can help with children at home, taking an interest in the reading and what they're learning, and modeling this interest in education at home. So we've added that. We, again, have the book lists, and let's see, the worksheets. So let me show you something new. What I'd like to show you now is vocabulary. So in vocabulary, under Common Core Standards, there is something called academic vocabulary. And sorry about this. OK, there's something called academic vocabulary. We have created these lists in both English and in Spanish. And here's the one in Spanish. So what we've done is we've gone ahead and separated them out into cognados and non-cognados. These abolir, abolish, these words that are very similar in both English and Spanish. And we work with ELA and ELL specialists to pull these out. The idea here is that we would like parents to print this list out and put it on the fridge. These are words that whether kids know them in English or Spanish, especially these cognados, it's going to help them. Knowing these academic vocabulary words are going to be helpful. And we've got them for grades 3 through 8. We are going to very soon have starting in January, we'll have an academic vocabulary texting program where parents can sign up and receive one word with a definition or a way to introduce that word into your child's vocabulary. Just a light, easy way to help people help parents help their kids learn these important academic vocabulary words throughout the year. And that's going to be available in English and in Spanish. Let's see. Okay, I would like to show you, I'm going to move away from fifth grade really quick, because one of the things that we've done is 6th, 7th, and 8th grade math. Once you get into 6th, 7th, and 8th grade math, it gets a little tough. Not everyone remembers 8th grade math or remembers it kindly. And so what we've done is we've tried to not teach math, but give enough so that parents who still want to be involved in helping, give them a leg up, give them a chance. Give them a chance to help. And so we've done this in English and in Spanish. We've still got the what it means with the bullet points, just showing the quick and dirty on what it is. And then the want to know more, we go a little deeper, and we've added some more videos. And what we've done in 6th, 7th, and 8th grade math, especially because middle school is a little bit different and parents are a little less involved in the absolute day-to-day than they were in elementary school for the most part. So what we've added are these videos from a math teacher for 6th, 7th, and 8th. What's the one thing that kids need to learn in this grade before they move on? So let me show you this video with Mr. Day, who is a math teacher in the DC area.
In my 8th grade classroom, I really focused my students on understanding the concept of a function, in particular focusing on linear functions, where one quantity is related to another with some initial value and then a constant rate of change. For example, if a gym charges a registration fee of $50 and then $20 per month, if I gave that scenario to my students, I'd want them to be able to build a function that relates that registration fee as an initial value and then the monthly fee as a rate of change.
The idea here is that parents aren't looking to relearn 8th grade math, but they do need to know what it is their kids really need to know before they move on. So obviously functions aren't the only thing, but they're the main thing for 8th grade math. And then we go on and we explain with some detail and increasingly using pictures to help with understanding all the different themes within the major content of math in 8th grade. And then again, we have the sample problems with solutions all in Spanish. And then back in How to Help, of course we have Start With a Good Attitude. We've got Carol Dweck, who is the researcher behind the mindset movement and the power of yet, the idea that you aren't born knowing things, you work really hard to learn them and then you know them. So you don't know something yet, but you will learn it. And then we've got the sprinkles and the boosts. The sprinkles again are the activities parents can do at home, and the boosts are the links to math games and videos and worksheets, and how to speak with your child's teacher. And so I mentioned that this is a living, breathing document, and one thing that we haven't added yet but we're about to is there is a leading education researcher named Annie Murphy-Paul, and we have two new videos from her. And one is about how children can learn from testing. And so that's pretty cool. And we're going to have that in English and in Spanish. And then the other one is about test stress and how parents can help their children reduce stress around tests and before tests. And that, again, in English and Spanish. So you can look for those to appear in the next week. So we're really excited about that. So that is a lot on our tool, and there's a lot to digest here. So I encourage everyone to play around, but switch between ELA and math, switch between the grades, switch between what it means and how to help, and please, like, let us know what you think of this tool. If you have ideas of things we should add or where we could be more clear, I'm definitely open to your input. And with that, I'm going to go ahead and open it up to questions and turn it back to Jessica.
Thank you, Jessica. That was really wonderful, and it was great to walk through both the English and Spanish resources and see more of the videos that you all have developed. Folks, please feel free now to chat in your questions. We have Jessica's time for the next 20 minutes, so it would be really great for you for us to use this opportunity to ask any burning questions. And so while I let folks do that, Jessica, I have one question for you. How can we find out about these new, you know, throughout the presentation you flagged a few areas where there will be content in Spanish or where there will be new videos. Is there a way for us to sign up via email or some other way to know when there are new parts of the website developed?
Actually, for the most part, I would say that all of the resources that I mentioned will be in Spanish soon. You can look in 1 week. Those will be live in a week. So for those, okay. you don't need to sign up. It's we're just cleaning them up and putting them live as we go. Because you know, some things have lagged in translation, but you can look for those in the next week. But we do have a weekly newsletter, and we are starting grade by grade newsletters. And I would suggest signing up for both, actually. I think both would be incredibly valuable. Let me get you, when you first open the state test guide, you will be prompted to sign up for the newsletters, and I think that that's a really great idea. But I will also get you a link for where you can sign up for a newsletter. I believe at the bottom of the tool, yeah, right here. Get the Great Schools newsletter if you sign up right here, and that's the bottom of every page. That's a great way because every time we release something new, we release it in the newsletter first.
Great. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. So I have one other question for you. Folks, please feel free to chat in your questions. Jessica, I think you've done a great job because we haven't received any questions yet, but I was hoping, could you share a little bit about your process, your and your colleagues' process for developing the Spanish tools? You mentioned that you worked with English, with ELL experts. Could you share a little more about what you did? Because I know that a lot of thought and work has gone into ensuring that that the resources are culturally and linguistically relevant to our Latino students, the Spanish ones. And so I would love to hear if you can speak to that a little.
Absolutely. So we hired two writers to come in on staff to do the writing for this project. And then and the writer, we hired an ELL teacher who has a journalism degree. And so she has in-class experience teaching in Spanish. She is, Latina herself, and did a lot of the writing, but then she worked with ELL teachers in Park and SVAC states to modify the material where we might need to. So, for instance, when we started talking about complex texts, what is complex text for third grade and what does that mean? So we took care to put an example in, like this poem or this book. And for Hispanic parents, instead of one book, we used another, both on the same complex text list, but more familiar. So Charlotte's Web is a known entity for English-speaking parents, but what we did was we replaced, in that case, a book that's a better match for Hispanic parents. And the title right now is escaping me, but you can find that in third grade. So we did that in a few different places. Wherever we're giving an example, we tried to make it an example that's going to be relevant to Hispanic parents. Let's
Great.
See.
And I have the opportunity to participate in a focus group you all led in Chicago in August, actually with one of our affiliates, Latino Policy Forum. And I'm not sure if you know about that work or if you can talk a little about that, or I'm happy to share that with the group here because I had the opportunity to participate in that.
Yeah, well, actually, if you want to talk about that one, we did a lot of focus groups. And I did hear, I got, you know, the high-level summary of the Chicago group, but we actually did parent groups here in the Bay Area as well, both in English and
great.
In Spanish. Yeah, and we got a lot of good feedback. And so actually, those bullet points at the top came straight out of parent feedback, and that's why we've got them all in PARC right now, and we're going to be adding them to SBAC as well. Just these the high-level bullet points.
Wonderful.
It's great. It's with math, but then we decided we should be doing it in English as well, or ELA as well.
Yeah, great. Okay, we have a question. Are there any representatives that will present the website and answer questions for a group of parents, like in a parent meeting? If so, who would be the contact person?
So absolutely, and I would first get in contact with Steve Padilla, and his contact info was on the last slide of the presentation, but it's spadilla@greatschools.org. And yes, absolutely, we would love that opportunity. And this can be done in Spanish, not by me, but it can be done in Spanish as well.
Thank you, Jessica. And the other thing I would say for both Guadalupe, thank you for that question, but other colleagues on the line is that myself, Jessica Rodriguez, this is my full-time job is supporting this work and the work being informing parents about how to best help their children with these new assessments and new academic standards and making sure that our Latino parents have the resources they need to help them with that. And so I would say that also, in the event that you guys are interested in anything like this, reach out to Great Schools, but also think of me as a resource to connect you with them as well. Any other questions? As Jessica mentioned at the beginning of the presentation, I will be following up with all of you over email, providing you with a link that has marketing and promotional items for you in case you are interested in sharing the news with your community or with your networks or printing promotional items to include in tabling events or workshops or in your own centers. So stay tuned for that. Since we are not receiving any more questions, I would like to thank you, Jessica, and Great Schools again for taking the time to speak with us. I know that you guys released the PARC resources, what was it, last week, last Friday?
Yeah, last Friday.
Last Friday, and so I feel very grateful to be able to schedule this meeting with you all and have hot off the press presentation with our affiliate network and our national partners as well, some folks who are on the line. Thank you so much for that. It's really great. It's very timely that we can do this, especially before the holidays. Okay, we have two more questions, Jess. So
okay.
The second is, are these tools available in paper format?
Oh, yes. Yes, I'm so sorry I didn't mention this. Okay, so this guide, first and foremost, it was built to be on your phone. So if you just take your screen and push it down to iPhone size or, you know, smartphone size, the whole thing is, and this is why these are built like this. So it's meant to be used on a touchscreen, on your tablet, or on the go, because a lot of these parent tips are meant to be used on the go, you know, in the car, while you're waiting in line. But we also have included print this guide. And so right now you can print, if you did right now print this guide, you would get math 8th grade. So you can choose your subject and your grade, and you can print it all out. In the next week, as I keep mentioning, this week is so special, you're also going to get the option to email this guide. So you can email the subject and grade that you want and have it in your inbox.
Wonderful.
Which is something you might want to do as well with the academic words, because there are like 90 academic words per grade that every kid is expected to know now. And it's a big list, so it's something people might want to print out, but also email to their to themselves.
Thank you, William, for that question. Any other folks have questions, please chime in. Beth, I see that you have your hand raised. I'm going to unmute you if you'd like to chime in with your question. All right, Beth, you're live. Maybe we lost Beth. Beth, feel free to either email me or Jessica the question. Luis, I see that you're chatting. I will unmute you too in case you'd like to chime in. Hi, Luis.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Luis is also our colleague from LULAC. Thank you for joining. We have the next 10 minutes with Jessica, if you have some questions.
I'd love to put in one more thing. We share your opinion. This actually comes straight to us. We read all of these. It would be amazing if you have any comments on any of the material. If you want to email me directly, go ahead. That's like the perfect person to directly get something addressed, especially if you see a change that needs to be made. But giving us your opinion will go to the entire organization, and we are reading every comment that comes in. I also wanted to mention one difference between PARC and SBAC. For those of you who work with people in different states, or in if you're in a state that doesn't use either SBAC or PARC, but you're interested in sharing this guide, there's an interesting difference between math problems in PARC and SBAC states. And so both are obviously new Common Core aligned, but SBAC states have a particular emphasis on explaining your work or solving it multiple ways. So in a SBAC sample problem, you might see three answers, and one is drawing it, one is explaining it, and one is like just a straight up equation, which is kind of a marked difference from PARC, where there's a little bit more priority on getting the right answer and a little less. There's still priority on showing your work, but a little less on solving it three different ways, which I thought was pretty interesting. And so for those of you working with educators in different states, or you know, with all the many kids that move all the time, and I know because Great Schools has a big audience of parents that move, and you know, the Common Core standards is helping to level the playing field for kids that move from one state to the other. But that's a difference in math that's worth noting.
Thank you, Jessica. That's very interesting and great that you flagged that. I received an internal question about professional growth certificates for attending this webinar. I would encourage you to speak to your staff, your director at your organization. I'm happy to speak with someone too, but we're not offering professional development certification for this. And our colleague Luis says, thanks for this great webinar. Really excited to be able to have this resource. Thank you, Luis.
Thank you.
Wonderful. Jessica, thank you so much. As I mentioned at the beginning, this webinar is recorded, and so we will, at NCLR, I will share the link over email. I will also be posting this on our NCLR Common Core webpage. You could access it by typing rumboaltriunfo.com or by emailing me. Again, thank you, Jessica. Thank you to Steve. Steve was very sick today, and so I appreciate you jumping right in, Jessica, to help us today with this. We are getting more feedback. We're getting more feedback that this was an awesome webinar and very informative, so I'm very glad to hear that.
Wow, thank you. I appreciate that. I appreciate your time. I hope that you find this helpful, and please let me know if you see anything we should do better.
Okay, great. All right, thank you. I'm going to stop the recording and email everyone later this afternoon with the links and the webinar recording. And Jessica, thank you very much.
Thank you.